Hey there, guys, and welcome again to Let's Play Enderman, episode 46. Yes, 46. Oh, yeah. This episode, we're gonna do a couple things. Work on the Iron Golem farm, and also on our new house. So, what I'm gonna do first is some more cobble, because we need more stone. And I'm just gonna finish up with what I have, and that will probably be it. So, yeah, I'll show you guys how the Iron Golem farm is, and then we'll teleport over to our new house. So, how many stacks do we have? 5 stacks of stone. That won't be enough, but I guess we can always come back and get more. So let's jump over to our Iron Golem farm and see what we got. Whoops. That was no good. So what I've done so far is expanded it up into the sky. I made 2 more, so we have a total of 6 spawning pads now. And yeah, gonna need a few more than that because it's not fast enough. So here we are. There we go. So yeah, we have the ones here and ones in the sky. All the way up there, so they're 70 blocks apart run from the other end. That's 1, 2, 3. Yep. So, ooh, we got some iron golems already. I'm planning to expand this ice farm because here it's pretty good when you're AFK waiting for golems to spawn, and the water freezes too, so it's pretty cool. And so now we have one up there, directly over there. The iron golems drop right there. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, and the 2 on that side. I still need to do those other 2. And yeah, let's get these iron golems. Whoa. Take food. Added a new AFK spot. Wow, that's loud. Oh, go fast. We have a new AFK spot over here, so that's a door out. This is a door inside, free from offs. Very nice. So now let's teleport to 084,000. Perfect. Okay, so we are going to do one circle today, and that will be a building circle. It will be where we have our storage space, and what else do we have in that sector of the village? Okay, block storage, item storage, potion storage, and library and furnaces. Okay, so we need to choose a corner to build it, so has to be one of these 4. Not sure where I want it though. So over in this corner we have a really awesome mountain biome. So, and over in that corner, we have just a grassy flatland and a little bit of a mixed forest over there, and it rains. Over here, I think we just have desert. Only desert? Well, we have the desert hills, and let's wait for this to load. Yeah, seems like just desert over that way. And finally, on our last corner, another mixed forest on this side. So, we gotta choose one of these four corners to build our storage circle. So, I'm thinking to have a bit of contrast because two of our City of Ender chunks are gonna be farms for animals and vegetables, and the other two are gonna be buildings. So, to compensate for the dry land of the desert, I think we're gonna put the two farms on that one and this one, which are in the desert, and then the building circles on those two. So, yeah, I'm not sure if it's actually gonna fit here with those mountains so close by. Might have to dig up a bit. Yeah, but here it rains, that's the problem. These two it rains because it's not a desert, and over here it doesn't rain because it's a desert. So, that's a hard choice. Well, I'm gonna think about it for a bit and start building the circle. And I guess I'll show you guys when I'm done. I have to choose between four places to put this. And yeah, so see you guys soon. We're back again. And as I was, well, I chose this place, first of all, to build it because it's not rainy and it's also close to something green, and I think it's a pretty good spot. So the torches mark the outside edge of the circle, which is 32 blocks away from the center, and I was wondering why there were no mobs spawning on these platforms, and I'm guessing it's because the desert below gives a very good spawning pad for all of them. Ouch! Ouch. And as I was putting the torches over here, I just walked over this way and check out what I found. Oh, it's not loading now. Let me load it for a second. There we go. Yep, there was a desert temple just right over there, and we couldn't see it because you need to be around here, I guess, for that part to load. And when we were over here, we couldn't see it. So, yeah, it's almost daytime. Let's go and check it out. I'm really curious. I didn't see this before. That's awesome. So, yeah. See if we get anything awesome inside. Okay, first of all, light up the top over here. And let's go through here. No mobs. Okay, let's go down like we did in the other one to the side. Oh shoot. Yeah, it's glitchy in 1.3 when you have an efficiency pickaxe and try to mine it quickly. Very lucky that's a stone pressure plate, not a wooden one, because that would be just so dangerous that a block lands on it. Ah, stupid glitches. Okay. it's deactivated. Whoops. A bit too fast, I guess. Yes, smart TNT. Very nice. And let's see what we got in the chests. Lovely. Wait, there was... Yes, I know that one doesn't go there, but I'm too lazy. Okay, so we got this, got sandstone, put this over here. Okay, let's see what we got. Gold, bread and flesh, iron, bones, bread and flesh, more gold, bones, bread and flesh, and more gold, bones, and bread and flesh. That's stupid. And four chests. Wow. We gotta find a jungle temple sometime. I've just looked everywhere and they're so hard to find. Much rarer than these desert temples. And desert villages are also very rare. Just, I don't understand why there aren't any around. Oh, maybe that we're here, we should... Oh, that looks very cool from here. Let's, no, I'll keep it. Very nice. Gold. Might as well check out if there's any other desert structure on this side of these mountains. Because if there is, we probably missed it. Well, we can always TP back home easily, so... Ooh, cows, we have flatlands, and wow, loading stuff in 1.3 is really slow. So I think that in a few months I'm actually going to buy a new processor for my computer, and it will just do it instantly, way faster than what we have now. So let's wait for this to load. Okay, mostly loaded now. Check my recording. Okay. Let's go over there in the grasslands. There might be a village here, because they usually spawn more in grasslands than they do in deserts. So there's a chance. Ouch. Oh, more mountain biomes, it seems. What is this? Oh man, this is loading.
Well guys, here it is. This isn't completed, but it is a quarter. And that's taken me for maybe about half an hour.
And now I'm waiting for more stone to smelt. So what I think, cobblestone to smelt. So what I think I'm going to do is bring a bunch of furnaces over here so that while I'm working on this, that can smelt. Because if I'm not at the village, it's not going to be working, so that way I can have stone while it makes me stone. So yeah, we might actually have to start shaft mining because I'm running out of cobblestone. I only have like a double chest and a half left, and we're gonna need a lot more than that. I've used maybe 12 stacks, 14 stacks on one quarter of the circle, and it's gonna be a lot more for the other three quarters. And eventually we're also gonna have one there, and one there. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Although you don't see the desert temple from here. And my render distance is on far. It doesn't seem as far as it used to be though. And I don't think recording affects it. So yeah, but if you go to the edge of the circle, it will. So this is a quarter, and I figured out how to do the perfect edges to make a circle with squares, which isn't very easy, with the one in the single player world I made with MC Edit. That one just takes the algorithm and does it for you. So that's 6, 4, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, and 1-1, and same on the other side. So yeah, I'm gonna have to do that 3 more times and we will finally have our circle. Can I just imagine it?
Hard circle of stone. And yeah, it's gonna take a very long time. So I guess I'll see you guys back here when I'm at 2 quarters. I'll do an update on every quarter, I guess. And it's also getting quite dark under there, as you can see. When we have the full circle, though, that will be very dark. And be like a mob spawner. Could have a mob arena under our Ender City. So, yeah, I'm going to continue this until I'm out of stone, and then I'll bring the, I'll make furnaces over here, start smelting more coal. See you guys in another bit. Hello there again. Yeah, I've finished 2 quarters now, and I brought some cobblestone over, and smelting it using planks, wood planks, because I'm kind of running out of coal. I only have a double chest now, and I'll need to go mining again, so that way I can get cobblestone, and coal, and iron, because we're going to need iron, and we'll also be able to use some lava buckets, since it doesn't consume the bucket anymore when you put it in the furnace. That will help a lot, but I need to find a good lava pool nearby so that we can easily go down there and get more lava, because every time it runs out, we're going to need to refill it. So here I am, smelting some more cobblestone, and got some more stone to finish the last 2 quarters. So this is what we've got done so far. And yeah, let's go up, take a look. There's very few mobs spawning here, actually. I'm not sure if there's a problem with that, or I don't know. I guess since it's a big desert, mobs can spawn anywhere. Or maybe there's lots of caves underground, I'm not sure. Actually, if you really like that, it looks kind of cool. So, 2 quarters done, 2 quarters to go. And yes, that's what I meant by big. It's going to be huge, very huge, and it's going to look really cool too. So, yeah, let's go back down, and this is going to be our place where we have the item storage, block storage, and library, furnaces, and potion storage. So we're gonna have 4 buildings, one on each corner, and they're gonna be a triangular. That side's gonna be cut off. So instead of making it a square, which would kind of waste a bit more space, and I don't want to make it a circle because everything else is a circle already. So, yeah, when I fill in those 2 quarters, we're going to have a major dark spot under here. And a lot of mobs spawning during the day. So, I'm going to continue this, get a bit more stone. And, yeah. I think I'm going to take a break. My fingers kind of hurt. So, yeah, see you guys in another bit. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Entire circle finished, and it looks great. Just the size we need it to be. So, let's take a look from above. This is 32 radius, 64 diameter, and it's the size of... Each quarter has approximately 3 chunks, so about 12 chunks. And yes, it's very big. I'm going to have it divided into the quarters. Each quarter will have one of the buildings. So, yeah. Still going to need to get more stone, because to make the buildings, we're going to use stone bricks. So, we need to get that from smelting more cobblestone. So what I'm going to do next is start the mine shaft underground and dig up lots of cobble and lots of coal too, because we're going to need it. See if we can find a lava pool to use the lava to smelt the cobble, and we will begin the buildings. I also wanted to eventually want to have all the paths marked on both sides with iron blocks, but since we don't have enough iron blocks to do the entire thing, we're just gonna start with this circle, which will be our main circle, where we have the most important stuff, all our storage, and we're gonna make a cross in the middle of the circle, and that will be the path that we use to get to each building, and it will be like that. They meet at the middle, so diameter 64, and it will be 2, so 2 stacks across this way and 2 stacks across that way. That's 4 stacks. We have enough to do that. So also gonna go to the village to get the iron blocks, and we'll begin doing that too. So yeah, it's very nice. And if you go over to the edge of the circle over here, stupid leg. Over to this edge of the circle, the desert village looks really cool. There we go. Just has to load a bit. At nighttime, it looks really cool with the lights inside the towers. And I want to take a look at it from the front. And yeah, so it's nice. I like it. So all we need now is to find a desert village and to find a jungle temple, which is obviously going to be very difficult, but oh well. Yes, look at that. Look at that. That's very nice on the inside too. Lots of XP from smelting the cobble as well, as you can see. If we ever need sandstone, we know where to come. What's wrong with those spiders? Whoa, that's a lot of spiders. Aha, escaped. Yes, so I'm gonna go mine a bit now, and after we'll go to the village, smelt some more cobble over here, and 16 furnaces, and I'm gonna continue later. So yeah, I guess see you guys in quite a few hours. Well, here I am. Well, I've mined a bit. Started the mine shaft, and right now I'm trying to get level 30 to enchant a new pickaxe because mine's almost dead. Oh no. Okay. Oh. And no, we don't have enough levels. Need just a few more and be able to enchant this new pickaxe. I've been fighting mobs down here for a while and at night, and yeah, so I broke a pickaxe and I don't want to use this efficiency for breaking 3, so what I'm trying to do is enchant a new one, see if I get anything worse, then I'll probably use this, but it seems like we are not getting any mobs under there, which is really weird actually. I thought we would. Since it's dark, I may have to go a bit farther away. Just one zombie. Oh well. And no, that's not enough. We need at least one mob, I think. Or two. Two mobs, yeah. And I'm out of food, too. Gotta go get some more steak. Is that another zombie? Oh, spiders, okay. Spiders are good too. Perfect, two of them. Let's go. And Yes, we're at level 30. Okay. So now all we have to do is teleport back home. Perfect. And we'll put these few items away. We're gonna get our iron blocks too to start those paths. 3 and 4. A lot of iron. This stuff goes here, that stuff doesn't. Okay. So, could we put this away? And put this away. And we're gonna go enchant. See if we get anything good. First, put away the gunpowder and spider eyes in our burning house. So, yeah, once I get the houses built on the buildings built on the chunk of our new Ender City, then I will start moving the chests and items and everything else you got in here. So, let's go enchant. Okay, that one is better, obviously, so I guess we're gonna end up using this one, and we're gonna save this, because I'm breaking 3, Fortune 3. This is awesome. I'm actually getting quite a lot of these pickaxes, which is very nice. No silk touch, though. I haven't gotten a silk touch yet. Stupid chickens. And yeah. So I've only got one silk touch pickaxe right now. It's this one. And I should actually put this one first. It's a most special one. Efficiency 5, 3, Fortune 3, efficiency 4, 3, efficiency 4, 3. Yeah, quite a lot of those. I think I'm gonna throw away this power 4 punch 2 bow, this power 4 bow, because it's not good enough and it only has one enchantment. So, yeah, I don't like it. Not good enough for me. Whoops, wrong one. Almost did that one off. And power 4 punch 2. Let me check if I have any other food other than steak, because I really don't like wasting steak that much. Oh yeah, we got bread. Finish up this bread, because I don't really collect bread. Once we move into our new Ender City and we have the farm set up, I will start stacking up bread and any other stuff we can get. Because these farms are too small here, I'm not gonna bother with that. So. Back here. Been collecting quite a bit of cobblestone and some stuff from mining. And this too. Finish up those 4. And now what I'm gonna go do is put these iron blocks in the Ender City chunk we have over there. And begin smelting more stone to make stone bricks, which we will need. So, yeah. I think that's it for now. And, yeah. Bye for now. Well, guys, here we are again. And, let's get what's on right now. I've smelted a lot of cobblestone, and it actually went extremely fast using the lava buckets. I got almost a double chest full of stone already, and I'm also gonna pay Scapegoat for getting me some stone. I'm gonna pay him 54 emeralds for a double chest, so 1 emerald per stack of stone. And yeah, so I've put in all the iron blocks that we have, and we're out. I was able to do the cross in the middle of this circle, and the paths on either side. So this is what it looks like. This will be what it will be, and eventually we'll have it all iron blocks. But yeah, these torches are where I'm going to have the redstone lamps, and it's going to be powered from below. Because you can put switches on the underside of blocks, so you can just put a redstone lamp here and underneath. The wall will be all around the circle here, so no need for iron blocks there. So this is, torches are going to be redstone lamps. I'm not sure if I should space it out more, if this is good enough. It looks kind of close to me. I might want to put it every 8 blocks, because then it would be 15, 14, 13, 12, 11. Yeah, I might space it out every 8 blocks, and that will look less clustered, I guess. So, yeah, let's take a look actually at what I've mined out so far. We have this over here. It is an 8x8 square in either direction, and it will eventually be in that direction and that way too. So it's 8x8, just a square, and it's a giant shaft that way, and this is where I'm getting most of my cobblestone out. I already found diamonds over there. And yeah, so teleport back to our easy to remember coordinates, and here we are. So next thing we are going to do is begin the buildings. I think we're going to be making them out of stone bricks and stone slabs, stone stairs, and yeah, the walls will also eventually be made out of stone bricks too, but for now, we don't have enough to do that, so let's make some stone first. Too bad I don't have wood for the crafting table. Our buildings, I think I'm gonna put them one away from the edges, just to give it a bit more space. And it's gonna be pretty big. Okay, so the wall is here. I wanna leave 3 blocks, I think, before the wall. So 4 blocks before the edge. And do the same on the other side. This is what all our buildings are gonna look like in our new city of Ender. So, all 1, 2, 3. And then it will go diagonally from here. I'm gonna have a diagonal side, I think. I'm not sure if I would want to do this or make it just a square, but I think this actually uses space up better than a square would, since it's a circle. It's either this or okay, we gotta make this a bit closer. Yeah, move this up one more block, and I think that's gonna be the regular size, because that's big enough. We don't want it too big. And if we make it squares, it's not gonna look too nice on the circle. So let's continue this. Whoops. This isn't working out very well. Okay, so this is the size that we're going to use, the main template, and I think that should be good enough for us. It's also going to be pretty tall, not too tall though, so it's going to be triangle here and there and so on. So we'll also have like a small space behind it, but that's okay. Don't think that's much of a problem. Yeah. I'll space out those torches a bit more. And we'll start building this. Oh, this leg. Okay, so we're gonna have entrances on each side, which I think are going to be spaced out 3 blocks from here. We're gonna have a 3 block wide entrance. No, move it over one more. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And each floor is gonna be 3.5 blocks tall, so it's gonna be, the ceiling is gonna be made of upside down half slabs to give it a bit more space, but on the other floor we'll still have a flat surface that's not half underground or anything. So we've got square doorway, 3x3, I think that looks pretty good. Good enough. Nothing too special. We might eventually put piston doors in. So yeah, we would need to narrow it out. Well, we might as well do that already, right? That would be, make it 2. Then we'll have block retracted, piston, torches were here. Okay, that's good spacing. So I guess this is what I'm gonna be doing for next while. We're actually gonna have 4 of these. So it's gonna be a lot of stone. That's why I need Scapegoat 4 to help me a bit with that. So yeah, this is the entrance. You can go out this way. And there'll be 4 of these, so just like that. And that. Yeah, that's a really stupid glitch in 1.3 that sometimes when you jump off 2 or 3 blocks high, you take damage. And it's supposed to be only every 4 blocks, so very strange. Okay, so I'm gonna continue building these until they're mostly complete, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like, because it's gonna take a lot of stone and also a lot of stone slabs. So yeah, I'm gonna make 4 of these, which is gonna take a lot of stone. A lot of stone. And I think this is a good size. We'll probably have, the chest will probably be along the 2 walls, one that way, some this way, and we'll also do something like this in the center, if I can figure out where the center is. I think this should be good. Something like this to give us a bit more surface area. We'll also have chests along this side and this side. So chests there and here. And I think that should look pretty good. The space on the inside, I'm not sure what we could use it for. I'll probably just leave it empty. And we might be able to put some hidden traps or hidden chests or something. I'm not sure what though. So yeah, I think this is a good size. Desert temple there. The wall will be there. We'll have 2 block space and a big space behind it too. I think it probably will look weird, but kind of cool, with the wall not being flat, but full of corners. Well, we'll see how it looks once I get it built. And I think it's going to be about a stack per layer, so can't make it too high. Maybe 2 or 3 floors at the most. So, yeah, I think that's it for now. Let me show you guys, there's a big, really big dark spot under there. Go away. That was unexpected. Also, yeah. That's what I'm gonna be doing for the next while. I'll also probably mine a bit more to get more cobblestone and then smelt some more. So, yeah, this is gonna take a really long time, but I think I'll probably have to finish it next episode. I'm not sure, I'll have to check the time how long this has been, and yeah, we'll see. Well guys, I'm gonna end the episode with this, but we still have a few last things to do. I was just mining here for a little to get a bit more cobblestone, and as you can see, I already found diamonds right here, and yeah, it seems like it wouldn't be worth it to dig out such a huge area, 8x8, which is 64 blocks every one block wide. But yeah, it actually turns out to be very useful because there's both diamonds at this layer and at that layer. So if we only dug down here, we'd only find this. If we only dug out up there, we'd only find that. So yeah, it turns out to work out pretty good. I also found diamonds over there, so it's just 3 times we've already found diamonds in just this little really teensy-weensy space. So yeah, I'm gonna actually teleport to the village one sec to get a fortune pick so that we don't waste these diamonds. So yeah, I'm also gonna enchant a new pickaxe just to see if we can get silk touch, which would be very useful. And yeah, see you guys at the village. 16 diamonds from 10 pieces of diamond ore. Let's go make a new pickaxe. I'm going to have to get a few more levels. So yeah, 25, need to get to 30. And yeah, so quickly go do that. Uh-oh. Alright, we're gonna go enchant the pickaxe right now to finish this episode. And okay, so we're not 30 levels. Let's see if we get silk touch. And we don't. But yeah, that one's still pretty good. Only efficiency 3. Oh, I guess that's what we're gonna keep using. And so, also, I just wanted to. There we go. Yeah, I'm just gonna show you guys what I have left to. Well, what I've got done before I finish this episode. So, yeah. We used a lot of stone. And I'm gonna need to go mining even more. See if we get a few more diamonds, and we can also get more stone because this is what I have been working on. Yes, this is what the buildings are gonna look like. And if we go on top, that's the first floor. This is a second floor, I think. For now, I'm only gonna put 2 floors. If I need more, then I can always add them. But the floor is stone slabs. I tried stone brick slabs, but it didn't look as good. It looked all the same, and it just wasn't that nice. So yeah, I'm working on the second floor for that. I just need to put the roof on, and these two are just the first floor. So I think it looks very nice. With 1 block space around here. I need to add lighting in too. So, yeah, that's what we're gonna be working on next episode, adding lighting in here and finishing up these buildings. So, yeah, this is what it is, and we'll see more progress next episode. So, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoy the Ultra Hardcore series I'm uploading, which I did with some of my friends. And yeah, that was just a practice run, and I think I did pretty good. I was third last, so it's pretty nice. And see you guys next time.